Tesla vs. Aptera, the efficiency challenge, part 2. Welcome to Aptera Challenge, and welcome back if you are one of the 78 subs supporting Aptera Challenge on our way to 1,000 subs. You may not have $1,000 to invest in Aptera, but it's free to like, subscribe or leave a comment below, thus enabling the mission of Aptera Challenge to help bring to market the most efficient, affordable electric vehicle ever produced. I would like to issue a challenge to anyone viewing this video today. So far, Aptera Challenge has achieved 78 subscribers from 3611 views, which is an efficiency of 2.16%. This is not Aptera efficient. So my challenge to you is, if you are not already subscribed, let's see if, with your help, we can get to 100 subs today if possible. So please, pause the video now, click that subscribe button, and leave a like and a comment to help with the YouTube algorithm. I came across a comment from someone who has a Tesla Model Y and averages 270 watt-hours per mile, but when they drive at under 40 miles per hour they can average 225 watt-hours per mile. Of course this is true, and it validates the fact that efficiency declines the faster you are driving, partly because the electric motor is not 100% efficient, and the faster it spins under load, the more energy it wastes, but mainly it's the extra load created by drag on the car that exponentially increases the energy consumption as you go over 40 miles per hour. When you get up to 70 miles per hour, that drag is really having a big effect on energy consumption, so this is where the difference between a drag coefficient of 0.13 and 0.23 really comes into effect. In an Aptera, if you are observing the speed limit, you are going to get much less energy wastage than a Tesla Model 3 or Y. That's not only because of lower drag, it's also because of less weight, which means less friction from the weight of the car pressing down on the tires as they rotate on the road surface. Let's take the example of that Model Y, which uses 20% more energy at highway speeds than at speeds less than 40 miles per hour. Let's say that the Aptera reduces that drag penalty to 10%. So if the Aptera uses 100 watt-hours per mile at slower speeds, it would use 110 watt-hours per mile at highway speeds. That's still half the energy consumption of that Model Y. Even if the drag penalty is 15%, that's 115 watt-hours per mile, which is only a small increase from 110 watt-hours per mile. The point I am making is that Aptera is a total package which targets a number of different factors causing energy wastage, but tackling all of these factors at a time creates a synergy that gives amazing energy efficiency. I'm not knocking Tesla either, they have actually created the most efficient EV currently on the road, within the constraints of the way they are building their cars. But Aptera has started with a clean sheet of paper when designing their vehicle, and are using different materials, a different type of electric motor, a radically different shape and a three-wheel configuration which may be polarizing and controversial because of its appearance, but gets the job done. Tesla started with an existing ICE car, the Lotus Elise, and converted it to make their first electric car, the Roadster, and then came out with the Model S, which apart from being electric and more aerodynamic than most cars, really isn't much different in essence than the ICE cars that people already drive. Yes, they used some aluminum in the Model S to make it lighter, but they also used a more or less conventional drivetrain with an electric motor driving the car through a differential, unlike the Aptera, which uses in-wheel motors to reduce weight and also increase the energy saved by regenerative braking. I'm looking forward to one day driving my own Aptera to see exactly how far I can drive on a charge. I am even putting together a plan to travel when I retire and have more time on my hands. If I have an Aptera with 250 miles range, I can leave home, drive to a destination 250 miles away, stay for a week and then drive on to my next destination, and all my travel will be free as the car will recharge itself from the sun. Even if I have to pay to camp in a holiday park, they often have free power, so we could top up if needed. We could use the tent that you can option with an Aptera and sleep in the back of the car, or take an extra tent if we have to unpack for a week and spread out a little. There's plenty of room in the back of the Aptera to carry all our camping gear, including a small tent. So that's it for this video. Once again, please like, subscribe and ring the bell, and let's get Aptera Challenge to 100 subs today.